So for my Vision Tek school project, I have spent the last 4 weeks building this. It's a Bluetooth-controlled Arduino robot. So I've previously done a project with an Arduino where I just learned the basics and how to make some lights blink. So now I wanted to do a more advanced project. So with this project, I had a couple of tutorials that I followed, which I will link. Here they are. This is an instructable, and it covers what you need and some of the basics on how to put it together. However, I found that I also needed some more guidance, so I also used this video here. It has a slightly different setup, but it covers everything you need to know. So, the first thing I needed to do was to get the parts I needed. So, here's the basics. You need an Arduino, obviously. This is an Arduino Uno, although you can use other Arduinos. And you will plug the wires into these holes, and you'll need a cord that connects this Arduino to your laptop. You will also need these motors. They don't have to be these exact motors, but general battery-controlled motors, and some wheels to connect to those motors, such as these. This is the motor driver. It controls these motors, and I use these lithium-ion batteries, and I have also a case for this with wires. And then this is the Bluetooth module. So I discovered that it was cheaper to get a kit that contained everything I needed. So this is one on Amazon, and it has everything you need. See, here's the motor driver, the Arduino, and it also has some more things. So if you want to do another project in the future, you can also delve into that. One thing that kit in particular does not have that you will need are wires that with a thing on the end that will go into it. So just keep in mind that you'll still have to get a few things. Okay, so after getting the parts, it was time to start putting everything together. So I have here. This is when I began to attach the motors to the chassis. So these motors come with these wires attached, and one problem that I had was that they were kind of a delicate attachment, so I accidentally kept breaking them off and had to solder them back on, so be careful of that. And then you use these little screws to screw it onto this. Now these come with cardboard covers on them, which I didn't realize at first, so you need to peel those off. And then you'll find the yellow and clear ones, or whatever color you may have. Okay, and then we have... Whoops. Okay, and then we have the motor driver. So the motor driver, you will connect your motors to this. The positive wires will go into the same spot on each side. And the way you get those in there is you unscrew you will unscrew this and put the wire in there, and then you'll screw it back down. So for example, on this side you have both positive wires here, both negative here, and on this side is the opposite, both positive here, both negative there. And the motor driver gets its instructions from the Arduino. The Arduino will be connected by these pins here, and then it will tell the motors what to do. The Arduino can't directly control the motors, so that's why we also have to have this. So then we move on to connecting the Bluetooth module and the Arduino. So that will end up looking like this. All the connections that you will need, I have here. This picture is a little blurry, but it can show you all the connections you need. So the Bluetooth module, let's see, actually that's not in here. But the Bluetooth module will connect to the Arduino, and then this battery connects. You'll have your positive and negative wires of the battery. The positive wire connected to your battery will go in here, the negative will go in here. And then from there, you will also connect that to your Arduino, so then that is also getting power from the batteries. And then that is all explained in the videos that I have linked as well. And then, whoops, okay. And then after you've connected everything, as you connect everything, once you've connected the battery, the lights should all come on, and then you'll know that all of your circuits are complete. So the next step is to write the code for your Arduino. So in order to code your Arduino, what you need to do is go to the Arduino website. So you'll just type in Arduino, and from there, you'll be able to find the website, just click on it, and then you can go to software. And then what you want is online tools. Whoops, I'm wrong, I'm sorry. What you want is downloads. Okay, and then you'll go down and you'll click on whichever one of these that applies to your computer. So I have an Apple, so I'll click on Mac, and then you can press just download or donate. And from there, you'll be able to get this. So once you've downloaded this, you'll be able to write your code. So what you need to do is you will have a cord that connects your Arduino with your, okay, so you will have a cord. So here's your Arduino, and this is here, is where you plug in the cord, and then the other end will have a USB which plugs into your computer. And then once you've made that connection, you will be able to upload this code to your Arduino. And the code will tell your Arduino what it needs to be doing. It's the program. So you can copy and paste code from the internet, but it's best to understand what you're doing so that you can adjust it if something goes wrong. So here I have these four pins. Now these numbers are relating to what I have. These are relating to my Arduino. So the pins that I have wires plugged into, okay, it's hard to see, but these pins here have numbers. And the numbers 10, 11, 12, and 13 are wires that are also connected down to my motor driver. So I am programming those pins to connect to tell the motor driver what to do. So the Arduino is programmed to then tell the motor driver what to do, which then tells the motors what to do. So here we have 10, 11, 12. Now, the motors, they will, if input 1 is positive, have 5 volts, and input 2 is ground, the motor will spin forward. So here I have high and low. So that will make one side of the motor spin forward. Then here we have high and low, and that is for the other side. And then if you want the motors to go backwards, you'll have low and then high. And if you want it to turn right, both sides will be low, so both motors are off, they will not be spinning. And the other side, high, low, it'll spin forward. And etc. for each thing. Now you'll see I have numbers. So this says if T equals 1, if T equals 2, if T equals 3. Now that is relating to the app I'm using. So the app I chose to use, oh, here's the thing. So I discovered that This Arduino Bluetooth device is not going to connect to an Apple product. It has to be Android. So I tried that with my phone and it didn't work. So now here I have this Samsung tablet. And this tablet, I downloaded an app called Arduino Bluetooth Control. And it's a little blue robot waving hello. It shows it in the video that I linked. So once you have that, you will be able to connect. So you'll turn this on, and if you've not yet put the wheels on, they just snap onto the motors. It's super simple. So once you turn your battery on, everything should light up, and you should see this blinking. So then on your phone, tablet, whatever, you just go to your Bluetooth and you click on this, which is called HC06. So you click on that, and then you're going to have to enter a code, which is just 1234. And then it should connect. And then for this app, you'll be able to see that I have, you can't see that very well. But anyway, I have numbers. Now each number is relating to what I have there. So one should make both motors spin forward. By both motors, I mean each side, because to the motor driver, the motor connections are both going in at the same spot, so it could be one motor or two, and it wouldn't know the difference. So you have that, and then you press one, it should go forward, etc., to backwards, and then you will be able to make it go. So here I have a video of mine going forward, and left, etc. So, I think that's about it. Thank you for watching.